So we're in winter now and it's getting dark about 4 o'clock. So this next one is going to be a very welcome upgrade.
Yes, we put these LED lights in our ceiling when we put the ceiling up, but we never wired them in. So now it's time that we can actually do that, get some lights in here so we can carry on working into the evenings. So I'm currently in what will be our kitchen in the future, not too long hopefully. And at the back there's our bedroom and our bed already done. So we've got a total of, how many have we got, Tim? Seven lights? No. We've got eight lights. And the way that we have designed our lighting system is that we can switch on the front four and switch on the back four independently of each other, but also manage to do both sets from either here or from the bedroom. And we've also wanted to have some dimmer switches, so one here and one in the bedroom as well. So it's a bit of a strange sort of situation that we've got planned, but hopefully it should work out pretty well.
So if I'm currently sitting in the bed, if I'm waking up in the morning, I'm thinking of having a switch around about here, and I should be able to flick it on to turn on the kitchen over there, so that I don't have to bother getting out of bed to do that. Yeah, bit of a luxury.
It will be a nice luxury, won't it? So I think what we're going to do is we're going to start with each puck light at the very start here. We're going to wire it in. We've already done the wiring in a previous video. We did some pre-wiring. So the actual wires themselves are already running through the van and down towards our 12 volt hub down there, which is great. So we don't have to do that. Now it's just a case of actually getting them out of the ceiling without damaging them. So these are pretty good lights. They use 3 watts each or a quarter of an amp. So all together, it's really not using that much power at all. So,
although we have budgeted for being able to have them on for 16 hours a day.
Yeah. Right, so that's what it is. And there should be the wire here somewhere. Yeah, it's just tucked in there. I don't know if you can see it in there.
That would be really annoying if the wire got lost behind the ceiling.
Yep. So we're just going to get that connected to that wire and do the same for all of them.
So they just got little spring clips just to pop into the ceiling.
Yep, like that. And they just hold themselves on, which is quite simple, really.
Come on. Got it.
There we go. Right. So yeah, we're just using 3mm duplex wire for these. We'll just strip back the insulation that's just covering those, and then we've got the positive and negative in there. So we've decided that we're going to connect the LED lights with some spade connectors, and the reason we're going to do that is because if one fails or something in the future, we can just unclip it there, replace it if we need to, and clip it back on without having to replace the whole wiring. So now it's just a case of finding the right connector out of this giant bag that we've got here.
So new connectors for everything. So many different shapes and sizes.
So I think it'll be the red one that we use. We've got two of those ready. And then these are a little bit frayed and a bit messed up, so I'm just going to cut these off. Then we've got a nice wire stripper tool. It's very handy. I'm very glad we got this. That's one and two. It's pretty simple. Okay, so just put it in the colour-coded section here on our crimp tool. So pink to red, or red to red really. And just pop it there, and then we'll get the wire in. Yep, I think that's good. And then we'll just crimp it until it ratchets. There we go. And then these are heat shrink, so we'll just get an hot air gun on that and just make it nice and sealed.
Now you just got to do that. How many more times? Got eight lights, four connectors per light, plus all the other connectors going down. Well, let's get to it.
Okay. Okay, Tim's taller, so he's going to take over for this bit.
The nice thing about these strippers is they pull off this has got out insulation first to pull these two wires together, and then each wire is insulated as well, but I can just do that.
Lovely.
And then just do it again. Oh, like that.
Sweet.
So easy compared to the other ones, ridiculous. If you've got the right tool, that is. So we're using the red connectors on the actual light, which is the smallest one you can get, but these are too small for the thicker wire, the 3mm wire we've got going to the light. So we've got the yellow ones for that, which are a lot bigger, but fortunately, the actual spade parts are the same size, so they still connect together perfectly, which makes our life very simple, which is nice.
Nice.
red to red, and black to black. And that is one light.
Lovely.
Put it back in the ceiling now.
Seven more to go.
A bit awkward trying to get the wires in first. All right, there we go. All right, nice. One done. Last light done. One thing we realised when we started doing our electrics is there is actually a different crimp tool for the heat shrink connectors. So we did have some of the more standard just plastic ones. We chose to use the heat shrink ones because it's just a bit nicer, shrinks around and gives a bit of extra protection from moisture and a bit of strength on that. But the tool for these ones has two little kind of impressions that if you use it on the heat shrink one can actually damage the heat shrink because it's not designed for that. Always got to have the right tool for the job, which means for the electrics there's a lot of different niche tools for everything. So we just started going along now, wiring up the actual lights to the master positive and negative that's coming to each set of four lights. And it took us a bit of pondering actually to figure out how we were going to join them together, because we've got the wire coming up here along here and we need to get all of the lights connected into that. So we're going from four lights with the wires all down to just one set of wires coming out. So we're experimenting with wondering if we're about soldering different types of connectors and things like that. But in the end, we found these, which are called wago 221 connectors. We love these things already. These things are great. They're so easy to use. You just pull up this little lever, stick your wire in, clamp it down, and it makes a really nice, strong, solid connection. And crucially, allows us to join three wires together, because what we've got is, for example, here, this is the main wire that's coming for the positive and negative for this side of the lights in the kitchen. So we've just cut that, and then we've put one side going in there, one side going in there, and then we've got this light, in this case, it's coming down and joining in the middle. So that basically means what we're going to be doing is our main wire is going to come in to each of these, and then we've got one light coming out as well. So one continuous wire with all the lights just dotted all the way along. And on the end here, that's the main light wire, after it's the positive and negative kitchen light wire. And then joined into that one, we've got the park light one and park light two. So that just keeps it all nice and connected. And yeah, you can see how easy these things are. Literally just, that's it. You just slide them in like so and press down the lever. There we go. Easy. That's all of the lights now wired into this wire going down here. Or there's four for the bedroom going that way and four for the kitchen going down that way. And they're connected with those wagos, so that's really good. So now what we've got to do is we're just kind of working our way down. We've got to do all the switches for it and actually connect to the battery. And the switches is a little bit interesting because obviously we like to make things complicated for ourselves, don't we? So this is what we're going to go for. This is our plan, so in theory we'll see if this actually works.
We do like our little diagrams, don't we?
Yeah, so we've got the four lights in the bedroom. That's LED 1, 2, 3 and 4. And then the four lights in the kitchen, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And each of those just has their own positive and negative wire coming off. And we've connected those in parallel using the wago. So this is a bit where the wago is connected into the main wire coming down. So then our switches. So again, what we want is to be able to turn on the bedroom from in the bedroom, like around here on the bed, and also near the door over there in the kitchen. And then the same for the kitchen the other way around. So what we've got is some two-way switches.
which basically look like this. It's just a little nice rocker switch like that. And they've got three prongs coming out. And there's going to be one on that side, like that, and one on the other side. And then the way these work is you've got a common terminal in the middle of each one, and we're going to wire in the positive to that one, and then out the other one. And then in the switch, when you switch it, there's a little bit that will connect either the top wire there or the bottom wire there. So if the idea is that we can always turn it on or off from either switch, it doesn't matter what state they're in. So if they're both in the on-up position, then the lights will be on. If they're both in the down position, then the current will flow this way and the lights will be on. And if you flip either one, it'll be one pointing onto the bottom wire, one to the top wire, and nothing will flow. So that will cut the power and the lights will be off. So that should work. But then, to make it a little bit more interesting as well, we also thought it'd be nice to be able to dim the lights, because we actually never turn these on, so we don't know how bright they are. But we thought it'd be quite nice if we could, you know, dial down the lighting a little bit in the evening. Maybe just have, you're watching a movie or something, you might just want just low level lighting. So
a bit of ambiance.
Yeah, so what we did for that, so we bought this little dimmer switch here. So it's touch sensitive, so the way it should work is when you tap on your finger on there, it should just dim the lights basically. So again, this is a theory. What we're going to do is wire it in after the switches. So power will come up from the battery through the first switch, and assuming the power is, the switch is on, or it's in a configuration with both of them that'll be on, then it'll go through the dimmer, up to the lights, and then back through the negative, back down there. And yeah, this switch, this dimmer, is designed to go and plug into an LED light strip, so it's got this little connector on the end. We're just going to chop those off, and then hopefully we can just hardwire it into the circuit. There's two wires on this side, two wires on that side. That is the plan. And then what we've done is just to mount them, we've just temporarily made this little, we've knocked this up in about 5 minutes, didn't we, Abby? We just got a piece of plywood, just cut some holes in it. So that's kind of what we're going for, that's what it looked like.
It looks pretty neat.
Yeah, when we build the wall properly, we'll actually put them in and do it properly. But for now, that should be how it goes. And then, yeah.
Awesome.
See if it works.
Ridiculous to set up is, but it's for a reason. Here we go.
That's so that is one side done. It looks complicated, doesn't it?
It does, but again, it's for a reason. So should work, hopefully. We'll find out later. Right, let's get some lunch. Carry on.
Getting so close now. It's quite exciting, the last little bit.
Yep.
That's nice and warm. Who needs a heater when you've got a heater?
Well, I don't have my coat on. So these are our two switch wires going between the kitchen and the bedroom and then back again. We already had some duplex wire with negative and positive cables in them, so black and red. But we thought we may as well use them because they've already got two wires in there. But obviously all of these are actually going to be positive. So we're just going to put some heat shrink over the black just to make sure that we know that those are all going to be positive. Just like that. So there we go. So now it'll all be red. We won't get confused.
Yeah, so those two wires, they're just... There's one for each switch.
This one is the kitchen wire.
Kitchen wire and then the bedroom wire with two. And that's going along there because that's one set of switches on one side and the other set will be there on the other side, the bit we're doing at the moment. And that corresponds to these ones here. So this is just one pair of duplex wires going from that switch to that switch and then again from that switch to that switch. Do you think it's all going to work when we turn it on?
It better do.
So yeah, with the dimmer, what we're going to do, what we're doing is cutting off these connectors. So we don't need these anymore. So they can just go straight away. And then these just peel back. A little bit tricky, but there are actually two wires here. So there's a positive and negative on each side. Because on these jacks, the negative is a bit around the outside and the positive is the one inside. So that's there like that. And then the one last, tricky part is working out which one of each pair is a positive and negative. There is some markings on here but they don't actually say positive and negative, it's just some grey dashes, so you can really figure out if there's just a convention for that, so hopefully we can test it. What we're thinking is there is a diode in here, an LED, and that lights up that ring, and diodes only work one way, so with current flowing one way. So there's a diode testing thing on our multimeter. So then if we test these two, and then we've got a reading of open lead, which basically means it's the wrong way round, I believe. So if we go the other way, then we get a value. So I think that tells us that this one is the positive, and that's the one that's got the dashes on, which is the same as it was on the other side. So that's what we're going with, and we will see if it works when we actually wire it all and switch it on. I think that this is the side that goes towards the power supply, so that would normally plug into a power adapter, and then this would be the side that plugs into your lights. So there's two different connectors.
So we'll just get our little switches into their panels first.
One dimmer installed. About to have lights. Don't go.
Do.
Okay.
Here we are. So we'll do this side for the kitchen and this side for the bedroom.
Yeah, makes
so
sense.
So this is our switch wire for the kitchen.
So that's just two positives.
So they both go on there.
We just put spade connectors on the end, which is all you need to connect them up.
Yep. And one on there.
Cool.
So this one is the switch wire for the bedroom. So we'll do one again. On there, and the other one. There we are.
It's just a case of finding the wire that's left now,
isn't
it? Yeah,
I'm getting confused now. So, positive bedroom light. So that will go on that one.
Yes.
Because that's the switch wire for the bedroom. Okay, and then the negative kitchen light will go on to one of these.
So that is the battery side.
Negative
switch, I think.
Which is this one.
Yes.
Okay. Oh my god, so confusing. And then we've got, so these are the wires coming from this set of four lights up here. Positive and negative kitchen lights. So this is our kitchen light here. So that one goes on positive to positive.
Yeah, positive that one.
Okay, and then the negative of those lights goes to the negative of
the dimmer.
There.
And then the only one left should be the battery side positive wire. Yeah,
which
perfect.
Which goes into there.
To the last socket remaining, yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Little Frankenstein mess of wires going on here.
Wow. It's the wrong connector, Tim.
Oh, whoops. My bad. It was going so well until that.
Is that right? Yeah, it's the, we put the male spade instead of the female spade on it.
Got a bit carried away.
Oh, okay.
All right, let's fix that.
All right, never mind. That's better.
Take two.
Let's hope it's still long enough, which it should be. There we go. Right.
One completed light switch panel.
Yes. Whew, now, we'll just wire it in down there and that should be it. So obviously these wires were already here when we did our pre-wiring. So yeah, we're just going to get the positive wires down below and then the negative up there at the top. And the last thing we'll do is just pop a couple of fuses in just before we turn them on.
Just cut this back, probably about there, because we can push it back through. We just need to strip that.
Get it in. Jackson, this is not the best time to be looking for cuddles.
He always comes right at the end, and when we've just finished the bed, just about to turn on the lights. He's like, can't be bothered to watch you actually do the making of it. He just wants the reward at the end. What are you doing? All right, that is the last bit wired in, I think.
One, and then this one's here.
Yep.
Okay.
So if you want to run round. Okay, so that's power to the whole system now, and then we've got the isolator for the 12 volt block. So we've got to turn on that. You can hear the fan noise.
Okay.
So everything is now powered up.
please. So let's try one.
So yeah, so
ready?
In theory.
Please. birthday!
Yay! Look at that! That's awesome!
And the other one?
Okay, well, one worked.
Okay.
I actually got lights coming out.
Oh, that's so cool.
Just got to figure out why the other side doesn't work. We probably wired it the wrong way around somewhere.
Maybe.
All right, let's try and figure that out now.
So we've done a little bit of jiggery pokery, and we think we've worked out the problem. Was when we put in these spotlights, the connectors there, we forgot to wrap them up in electrical tape at the time and probably shorted it out somewhere.
Yeah, you could hear the fuse pop actually.
Yeah, exactly. So we probably got lucky with these because they turned on, but those ones didn't. So now I can turn on the bedroom lights from here. Ready, steady. Yay! There we go. And we've got our dimmer, should be working on this side. Getting a bit brighter. And getting a bit dimmer.
Nice.
And it remembers as well. So if I switch them off here, then it goes back to what it was before you switch them on.
That's very cool. Off. And then, so I should be able to then turn on these ones over here. So
yep. This
is bedroom, this is kitchen. So if I turn this one off, bedroom goes off. And then you should be able to turn it right back on over there.
Okay.
Yeah. Bedroom on. And I can turn off kitchen. And you can turn kitchen on.
It works.
It's so satisfying.
The only one slight problem we've got is that the dimmer over there, for some reason, isn't working. We think it might be dud.
Yeah, this one, well, it's letting power go through it, but it's just...
not dimming.
Doesn't work.
But, you know, we can just get a replacement one, hopefully. But the most important thing is we've got some light, finally.
We also now have bugs in the van finding the lights already.
That's a new problem, isn't it? But I don't mind. Can actually start working into the evenings now.
I think now it feels a lot more homely in here, just get the lights in. It's amazing what difference it makes.
Hey, it makes quite a nice pattern in the garage through the slats.
Oh yeah. It's like a little disco going on down there. So with all the lights on in the van, that is 8 of these LEDs. We're using 17 watts, which is pretty cool. If we try the dimmer over here, so we just touch and hold, turn down the brightness of those ones. Yeah, you can see that's dropped from 17 to 9 watts. So yeah, we can have some low power mood lighting going on.
So we're really happy with how that turned out, and I'm glad we went for the two-way switch in the end. Has made the wiring a little bit more complicated, but I think when we're on the road, we'll really appreciate that we can actually switch them off independently, so that's really good.
Yeah, I think so too. So we're not really sure what our next project is going to be, but it is really cold in here, so at some point soon we're going to have to get some heat.
Yeah, it's pretty chilly. That's all for this one. If you enjoy this video, don't forget you can subscribe below, and we'll see you next time.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
See you later.